let's start with the exercise 3.7. The age of the two friends, Honey and Biju, were differ by 3. So this is the first relation which says that the relation between Honey and Biju. Is it? So first equation we will get from here that the age of the two friends, which is elder, we don't know. So let the age of Honey be X and age of Biju be Y years. So X minus Y is equal to 3 years. This relation you get, which is pretty simple. Important thing is to think here. Now what has happened? Honey father Dharma is twice old as Honey, and Biju is twice as old as sister Kate. And now Honey is related with Dharma. Dharma father, his father, and Biju is related to the sister, and there is a relation between Dharma and Kathy, the sister of Biju, and Anis father Dharma. Got it? So there is indirect relation. First relation we got that Anis and Biju, is it, differ by 3. Then Anis is related with his father Dharma, and Biju is related with his sister Kete, and there is a relation between Dharma, Anis father, and Kete, the Biju sister. So Anis father Dharma and Biju sister Kete will give the second equation, is it? So what is here now? Anis father Dharma is twice as old as Anis. So Dharma is 2x. Is it? Anis age is x. So Dharma age is, for his father, Dharma age is 2x. Now, Biju is twice as old as his sister Kate. So Kate is half of Biju. Is it? So Biju is equal to we can say Kate is equal to y by 2. So these two relations. First relation we got a Dharma with Anis. Anis, is it? What is a Dharma? Dharma is 2x, twice the age of Anis, and Kate is half the age of Biju. So these two relation we got, 2x and y by 2. So the age of Kate and Dharma differ by 30 years. Naturally, Kate is younger because he is a sister, Dharma is a father, so he may be older. So Dharma, this is 2x minus y by 2 is equal to 30, is it? So see here, let the age of the two friends Anis and Biju be x year and y years. So x minus y is equal to 3. Anis father Dharma age will be 2x years, and Kate age will be, that Biju sister will be half, y by 2 years. So according to the condition, it is 2x minus y by 2 is 30. So simplify it and you'll get 4x minus y is equal to 60. So from solving first and second equation like this, you're changing the sign, you'll get x is equal to 19. If you substitute in the first equation, you'll get y is equal to 60 years. One says, give me 100 friend, I sell, then become twice as rich as you. The other reply, if you give me 10, I sell, be 6 times as rich as you. Tell me what is the amount respective capital has. Is it? So let the amount with 1 be rupees X, and the amount with the rupee, and the amount with the other be rupees Y. First condition, X says to Y, give me 100 rupees, so X plus 10. And the Y has to give 100, so it is to be Y minus 100. At that condition, first one, X plus 100 will become twice Y minus 100. Is it clear? Got it? Again, what I say? The first person says that give me 100 rupees, so it is plus to him, because it is, he get 100 rupees. So X plus 10. Y gives him, so it is Y minus 10. At that condition, what one says, that he will be having twice the amount what the second one has, means Y has. So therefore x plus 100 is equal to 2y minus 100. If you simplify it, you will get x minus 2y is equal to minus 300. Second condition, y say that if you give me 10, so y is added 10 rupees and x has to give 10 rupees because he is giving. So x minus 10. At that time, y says that he will be having 6 times what amount the left with the x. So it is 6x minus 10. So y plus 10 is equal to 6x into 6. 6 10 just 60 minus 60. So if you simplify it, you'll get minus 6x plus y is equal to minus 70. Simplifying this, multiplying the equation 1 by 1 and same, and second by 2, coefficient of x equals coefficient of y become equal, minus 2 and plus 2, so it will cancel out. Then you will get x value is equal to 40. Substituting in the equation 1, you will get y is equal to 170. And thus, the one has 40 rupees, another has 170 rupees. Train covers a certain distance at uniform speed. If the train would have been faster, faster means speed. Okay, faster, if the train would have been faster 10 km per hour, that is the speed, it would have taken 2 hours less than the scheduled time. So we have to find what is the scheduled time also. How we'll get time? What is t? D by s. Okay, what is the distance? D is equal to, or we can say speed is equal to, what is the speed? Distance upon time. So what is t? If you say it is d by s, is it? So scheduled time we have to find. Then it takes 2 hours less means 2 hours less it will be reduced. Is it? Because of difference of the speed. So we have to compare the speed, the normal speed, and when the speed is increased by 10 kilometers per hour, it takes 2 hours less means equate to 2 hours. Got it? And if the train would have been slower means it is reduced, then the usual speed means scheduled speed or normal speed, it would have taken 3 hours more than the scheduled time. Got it? We have to equate time. Find the distance covered by the train. Okay. So what we suppose, let the distance covered by the train be x, because we need to compare the speed, the faster. Speed become faster and slower. So this indicates that first we have to find the what is the speed. What is speed depend upon? So what distance we have to find? D. And s also we have to suppose to find that, to find it, the speed. Got it? S also we have to suppose speed, and then we'll get a scheduled time. Is it? Because of difference of speed, it takes 2 over less, we have to understand. So whatever x, or what we need to take x and y for comparing the time, is for comparing the speed. Okay, is 2 over less means what is a time. So we have to compare the time taken by the scheduled time, and if the time is increased by, if the speed is increased by 10 km, what will be the hour time we have to compare. So this is the difference of time. What I mean to is difference of time, first is uniform speed, and when it is traveling with the speed at more speed at 10 km per hour, because of difference of speed, this 2 hour is less. Is it? Okay, 2 hours means what is it? Time. So we have to find what is the scheduled time, then what is the schedule, what is the time when it is increased by the speed is increased. Okay, so let the distance covered by the train be x kilometer and uniform speed be y kilometer. So the time taken by the train to cover the distance x kilometers with the speed of y kilometers per hour be x upon y hour. This is called the scheduled time. Now if the train would be increased, if the speed of the train is increased, or if the train would be 10 kilometer hour faster, the new speed will be y plus 10 kilometers per hour. Got it? Then the time taken by train will be distance will remain the same, x upon y plus 10. And because of difference of this speed now, it takes, because of difference of speed, the time is taken difference. So what time taken here? Usual time, x upon y. What is the now time?
x upon y plus 10. Because of difference of these two, got it? It is take 2 over less. So you have to say is equal to 2 because of difference of these two. Is it, which is greater, which fraction is greater, x upon y or x upon y plus 10? This is lesser, got it? This is a greater because you are dividing x by y and you are dividing y plus, we are dividing x by y plus 10. So it will, value will be less. So therefore, what will take? Difference of, how will write it? X upon y minus x upon y plus 10 is equal to 2. Is it? If you make mistake, x upon y plus 10 minus x upon y, then it will be negative. Because you have to see which fraction is greater. This fraction is a greater. Got it clear? So condition according to that, y upon x upon y minus x upon y plus 10 is equal to 2. If you simplify it, okay, you will get 5x minus 10y is equal to y square. Is it? Okay. And now it will be y, not y square. So if the train would have taken 10 kilometers slower, then what will be then y minus 10? So the time taken would have been in that condition, in that situation, will be x upon y minus 10. So what is the scheduled time? X. Is it? Now this ratio is less because y minus 10 and y x upon y. X upon y minus 10 and x upon y. So this is less now. So this will come first. It takes 3 hours less. So x upon y minus 10 minus x upon y is equal to 3. If you simplify it, we'll get here 10x plus 30y is equal to 3y square. Is it? If you simplify it, we'll get y is equal to 50 kilometers per hour and x is equal to 60 kilometers per hour. The student of a class are made to stand in a row. So what will be the total number of students? Number of row into the number of students standing in a row will give you the total strength of the student. Okay, is it? First you have to understand, suppose the students are standing, okay, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 5, is it 5 in a row, 5, and there are 5, so 5 is a 25. The total number of students will be 25. So the students of a class are made to stand in a row. Is it? If 3 students are extra, 3 students means number of students is minus, then the row would be increased. Row means plus 1 row we have to write. If the 3 students are less means minus, then row would be, there would be 2 row more means y plus 2. Find the number of students in a class. So how will get number of student in the class? Number of row into the number of row in the number of student in each row. Is it? So let us suppose, what you have to suppose here? Okay, what? The number of student in each row. Let the number of student in each row is x and the number of row would be y. So total number of students is x into y. Understand? Let the number of student in each row be x and the number of row be y. So total number of student is x into y. Now what is the first condition? If 3 students are increased, 1 row is reduced. So x plus 3 into, it become y minus 1. Why it is into? Because number of students is equal to number of student in a row into the number of row. Number of student in row into the number of row. Is it? So number of students is equal to x into y. So if you simplify this, x and y will cancel out. You will get x minus 3y is equal to minus 3. Second condition, if the 3 students are less, okay, if the 3 students are less, then row is increased. Okay, 3 numbers, then y plus 2. This number of row is increased by 2. So if you simplify it, you will get 2x minus 3y is equal to 6. From first and second, with elimination method, you will get x is equal to 9. Substituting the value of x is equal to 9 into equation 1, you will get y is equal to 4. So thus, the number of students is x into y, that is 9 into 4, 36.